So here I was flying my slicer, trying to check out if the incursors in the plex is hostile. It didn't turn out that way, but right behind me was a pirate slicer. This was a pirate character from a well-known pirate alliance, Big Water Hooligans, who usually fly bigger and much more expensive stuff. What you see me do here is immediately click approach. You can click approach on someone even before they are lockable when they just enter a plex. In this case, I expect him to be kite fitted, as most slicers and certainly most pirate slicers are, and I want to get in a few close range shots before he speeds out of my range. I keep my mouse over the keep at range button, just in case he wants to brawl, so then I can be at my optimal distance. As he moves to 20 km, I quickly switch crystals and accidentally deactivate my afterburner instead of stopping overheating it. I keep on approaching him to let him land a few good hits, because I suspect my armor tank is better than his, and I want him to gain some confidence that he is ahead of me. Now that he's reached his optimal range, you see him stopping his micro warp drive and not moving anymore. This is a very smart idea, since it will allow him to get better hits on me. However, while he has stopped moving, I'm going to move instead and trying to approach him at an angle, so that his shots are less likely to hit me. Of course, I'm less likely to hit him as well, but since I expect my tank to be better than his, this is to my advantage. And there he goes. Now post a good fight in local, and let's see what loot he has. Since this guy is way too rich for his own good, I expect to find a lot of expensive stuff, and he was probably flying with drugs and boosters and pirate implants as well. Sometimes you will find that you can beat an experienced PvP'er, even if he flies a lot more expensive fit, on account of your own fit and your tactics. About 180 million in modules left, quite a nice haul. That same evening I got a fight with another really expensive slicer, this time a totally different fit. I immediately notice his odd speed. Afterburner slicers go between 1 to 1.5 km a second. Microwarp dive slicers are usually 4 km a second and sometimes faster. He is going between 3.5 and 3 km a second. This is an obvious sign of an oversized afterburner. He flies right past me, but gets in a couple of hits. This means his tracking is pretty good, probably better than mine, while it's difficult for me to maintain a particular range. Since his 10mm afterburner gives him a lot of speed, but not a lot of maneuverability, I count on him to bounce between 10 and 30 kilometers, so I fit my standard S-crystals to hit him all the time. I'm flying a beam slicer now, so my tracking is a lot worse than a pulse slicer, but at least I can hit out to 30 kilometers. In this case, his tracking is not only superior to mine, his tank is superior as well, which leaves me with little options. Post-fight analysis indicated he flew with a lot of abyssal mods and of course pirate implants as well. And sometimes even the best tactics cannot beat a good pilot with expensive stuff.